Hello everyone and welcome to the VE Precast YouTube channel. Chris Romani back here with you today. Today we're going to be talking about value engineering. Obviously, as a sales manager, I get asked all the time, "Hey Chris, I'm over budget. What can I do to get my costs down?" Well, I'm hoping today I can teach you a little bit about value engineering and how to look at your precast project to see if it's efficient. In my last video in the series, we talked about how precast is a high-performance material, which means it does a lot of things well. Now, even though it is efficient, in this video we want to talk about how can we maximize its efficiency. And so there's really three places that we can do this. We can do it in manufacturing, we can do it in logistics, and we can do it in the erection sequence. Let's take a look at an example right now. Now for this example, we're going to take a look at a standard bay of double T's. Now in case you're unfamiliar with precast, double T's on a parking garage are what you actually drive on. They can be held up by a couple things. One of them are columns and beams. Now what I have for you here is an example of what a double T looks like, a rough schematic in its dimensions, as well as in the bottom right a picture of the double T. Now suppose you have two buildings with a double T floor sitting side by side. Now one bay is pulled out of each of them. In the building on the left, three double T's 12 feet wide are used. In the building on the right, three double T's 10 feet wide and one double T 6 foot wide are used. Now take a moment and think about which building you think is going to be less expensive and why that is. If you guessed A, you were right. But let's take a look as to why. Now in example A, three identical pieces of precast were used. In example B, three identical pieces were used with a fourth separate piece being made. Now, example A does two really good things here. One, by making all pieces the same size, they're able to reduce the amount of labor at the manufacturing facility. Now, the second thing they do well is they conform to the precaster standards. In this case, like my plant, we make a 12-foot double T. We don't have to do much extra work for that. How will you know what a precaster standards are? Well, you're going to have to go and ask them. So contact your precaster as you're designing your structure to know what their standards are, and then you can make your bays the right shape and size. The logistics part should seem easy. Obviously, in example A, you're shipping three pieces, and in example B, you're shipping four. So it should be cheaper, right? While that's true, there's some other considerations. To answer these questions, you want to take a look at your site plan. When you're looking at your site plan, you want to remember that the precaster is going to bring between 8 and 12 90 to 100 foot long trucks on your site each day. Now, you want to ask yourself, how are these trucks going to enter and exit my site? Is it going to be easy? And how are they going to be able to pick off the crane? Now, when these two questions can be easily answered and there's an easy process, the precaster can expect to erect more pieces a day on your site. This will reduce duration of the erection time and therefore should save you money. Finally, the last place you can value engineer your structure is in erection. During the erection process, value engineering is all about the crane. By developing a plan where pick lengths are kept to a minimum, the number of picks can be increased per day. Now, as just mentioned in logistics, this will reduce the duration of the project, which should save you time as well as money. Additionally, by decreasing the lengths of picks, you may be able to use a smaller crane. Now, using a smaller crane will obviously save you additional funds. So now you have three areas that you can start value engineering your precast structure: manufacturing, logistics, and erection. Now, of course, for the most part, I talked about parking. That's a lot of what my company does, but these are applicable to pretty much any kind of precast. The key is understanding their standards and using them as you move forward. So whether it's a parking garage or some type of cladding, as long as you know the standards, you can build efficiently. So there you go. Now you can start value engineering your own precast project. If you've enjoyed this video, please like, comment, and subscribe to the series. I'll be posting more videos about value engineering as well as general precast tips. In the meantime, if you have any questions, email me at cjromani@gmail.com. Thanks and can't wait to see you on the next video.